Days to maturity is an important bit of information that trips some people up, especially beginner gardeners. And this is because the gardening industry is assuming that you understand the difference between something that is direct sown and transplanted. So you will see days to maturity listed for all annual vegetable seed products in catalog. And this corn, for example, says 78 days. Corn is a direct sown vegetable crop, so that 78 days means it's from the time that you plant the seed in the ground till the time that you are harvesting mature corn. And that same thing can be used for all direct sown crops, crops that go seed directly in the ground. And that's things like sweet corn, popcorn, cucumbers, melons, green beans, peas, all of your root crops like radishes, beets, parsnips, those types of things. It gets a little trickier when we get into non-direct sown items, transplanted items. Those are things that typically would be started indoors before it's warm enough to transplant. And then once the seedlings are about 6 to 8 weeks of age, they are transplanted out into either the garden or the container or wherever they are going to be grown to maturity. So that product group includes things like tomatoes, peppers, eggplant, broccoli, cabbage, cauliflower, things like that. And when you see that day to maturity on a, say on a tomato, for instance here, Gurney Girl's Best tomato, we've got 75 days. That is 75 days from the time that tomato transplant goes into the garden until you're harvesting ripe fruit. That number does not take into account the 6 to 8 weeks that it takes from the time that you start the seed indoors till you have a transplant-sized seedling. So always keep that in mind. So once you know the days to maturity of a certain variety, you can use that information to decide whether or not you can grow that specific variety in your own garden, your own growing climate at home. The way that you do this is that you'll want to figure out your last estimated frost date or danger of frost in the spring and your first estimated frost date in the fall. There are a lot of good resources online for figuring that. Garden.org and almanac.com both have a tool on their websites that you can actually just type in your zip code and it will pull up that information for you. Both of those websites are using database information that's pulling from the NOAA Environmental Information site, which collects weather and climate data from all over the place over a long, long, long period of time. You can actually go directly to the NOAA site as well, but it's not quite as user-friendly. So just type in your zip code, it will pull up your first and last frost date. You can then figure out how many days you have between that span. So for example, I am in zone 6, kind of mid-western Ohio. My first frost date in the fall is estimated at about October 6th. My last frost date in the spring is estimated at May 4th. That gives me 154 frost-free growing days. So I know that I'm safe to grow anything that falls below that 154-day threshold, which is pretty much everything. Not too many crops. We get a little dicey when it comes to some super long season subtropical, like vining crops, melons and winter squash, maybe even a few sweet potatoes. Our season is pretty much long enough to handle most anything. Now, again, that is just days. That's not taking into account any other growing information, but that's just so you know that your season is long enough to actually be able to grow something to maturity. One final thing to keep in mind about days to maturity is that this gets a little muddled when it comes to growing crops that are cold hardy or frost hardy. Things that you would typically plant in your spring or fall garden if you live in Ohio. Those are things like all the cold hardy greens. So kale, spinach, lettuce, chard, things like peas, onions, in particular things like cold hardy Asian greens, broccoli, cauliflower, fennel to some extent. The reason that this gets a little tricky is because those crops can actually continue to be grown after your danger of frost date in the fall and actually are often started before that spring frost date at the beginning of the season. So I found an easy way to figure planting time on this, honestly, is just to, again, handy old Google, do a Google search of like when to start frost tolerant crops in my area. And there are different, all kinds of different websites out there. Some of the most reliable are the university extensions. You really want to look for a reputable source for this information. I like the one that the Purdue extension lists. It will give you all of the crops that are frost hardy or cold hardy. And they basically tell you how many weeks before the frost you can sow, and then kind of what your expected harvest time is. So it's a really handy tool. But again, just be aware of days to maturity. Just realize that that is something that you need to look at before you start making decisions for your own home garden. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.